Hi, hello. So what's up guys? Welcome back to our MAM Academy channel with you, Vigneshwari ma'am, right? What we have discussed in our last class, atomic and molecular masses. In this video, we will be discussing about mole concept and molar masses. And also, second topic is percentage composition. Let me discuss about mole concept and molar masses. Atoms and molecules are extremely small in size and their numbers in even a small amount of any substance is really very large. To handle such large numbers, a unit of convenient magnitude is required. Let us say we need 24 apples. So we will collect them into two boxes. Just we denote one dozen for 12 items in each box. Here, dozen means unit of measurement. One dozen means 12. So, in one box, there are 12 apple will be there. So, dozen means it is unit of measurement that is help to simplify and the state of large quantity like 22. So when scientists provoking with the elements and the compounds, they have to do unit of measurement to count quantities at the microscopic level. So this SI base unit mole of introduce this amount of substance less mole. So they introduce the amount of substance. So mole is the amount of substance which is contained as many elementary entities as there are in 12 gram of carbon. So elementary entities may be atoms, molecules, atoms, proton, electron, molecules and ions. So note that one mole of substance always contain the same number of entities irrespectively identity and the kind of the substance. So the term of mole is used to count the particle of such as atoms, protons, electrons and molecules and ions. For example, one mole of hydrogen is correct. We must indicate the nature of the particles under observation. For example, this one mole of hydrogen, is it correct? It would be correct. No, it is incorrect. So we need to specify the entity relevant, that is hydrogen atom or hydrogen molecules. Thus correct terms would be one mole of hydrogen atom or one mole of hydrogen molecules. So these two terms are correct only. That is one mole of hydrogen atom and another one is one mole of hydrogen molecules. So next, what is the value of mole? So let us find out. We know that the 6 carbon 12 atoms is used to based calculate the atomic mass of an element. Hence, scientists used carbon based determined the value of one molecules. They used the mass spectrometer. So they used the mass spectrometer to determine the mass of carbon 12 atoms and find out it would be 1.99 2648 × 10⁻²⁷ gram. So 12 gram of mole of carbon 12 is divided by mass of carbon 12 atom. So we know that the carbon 12 masses, 12 gram mole of carbon 12 divided by the mass of carbon 12 atom is 1.992648 into 10 to the power of minus 23 gram. So we obtained the answer is 6.0221367 into 10 to the power of 23 atom or molecules. So this is the value. This value is the 1 mole of gram. So this is known as the Avogadro number. Avogadro's number or Avogadro constant. And in the honor of Amedeo Avogadro, and he usually represented as Na is equal to 6.0221367 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms or molecules. So Avogadro number or Avogadro constant is the number of elementary entities, which means atoms or molecules or ions in the 1 mole of a substance. So thus we can see that the 1 mole of water molecules contains 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules. That is, 1 mole of water is 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23 water molecule. So for us, therefore 1 mole of NaCl, which means sodium chloride, water 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23 formula unit of water. So having defined the mole, it is easier to know the mass of an 1 mole of a substance or the constituent entities. So molar mass is the mass of an 1 mole of substance. It is expressed in gram. So molar mass, atomic or molecular or formula mass in U, which means it is unified value. Let us determine the molar mass for water. So we know that the water comprises 2 hydrogen and 1 oxygen atom. We can obtain the masses of hydrogen and oxygen from the periodic table. So the atomic mass of hydrogen is 1.00794 and the atomic mass of oxygen is 15.9994. So the molar mass of water, that is 1.00794 addition 15.9994, when we add this we will get 18.0153, which means in gram 18.02 gram. So molar mass. And we know that the molar mass can be obtained by adding the atomic masses of all the atoms present in only one molecule of the substance. So molar mass numerically equivalent to the atomic. Molar mass equivalent to the atomic. So molar mass numerically equal to the atomic. So the molar mass of substance is equal to molar mass. So next our topic is percentage composition. Percentage composition. We have seen that how to determine the entities present in a substance. At times, scientists also required to know that percentage of elements present in the compound. So this information helps to determine the purity of the chemical compound under observation. So before that, we should know the percentage of composition. The percentage of composition of an element or constituents in a compound is the number of parts by mass of that elements or constituent present in a 100 parts by molar masses of the compound. So percentage of an element or constituent, number of parts by mass of the element or constituent divided by molar mass of the compound multiply 100. So let us look at the equation. We know that the molar mass of water is 18.02 gram. So we take this water H2O. Molar mass of water is 1.00794 plus 1.00794 plus multiply 15.994. So we get answer 18.0153. So when we round up it, we get answer 18.02 gram. So based on this percentage, we can calculate the percentage of hydrogen and a percentage of oxygen. So for 2 hydrogen, 2 into 1.008 divided by, for molar mass of water is 18.02. So we get answer 18.08, and the mass of oxygen is 16.00 divided by 18.02. We get answer 88.79%. So mass of hydrogen is, percentage of hydrogen is 11.08%, and mass percentage of oxygen is 88.79%. So the molar mass and the percentage composition help us to understand the quantity, the data associated with the chemical compound formula. But how to write a chemical compound? How did the science obtain the formula of H2O, which means water? Here, chemical formula of a compound is divided in two parts. That is empirical formula, another one is molecular formula. Let us discuss about empirical formula. The formula which gives the simplest whole number ratio of the different atoms present in one molecules of the compound. For example, water. We will take the example as water. So empirical formula of water is H2O. In H, hydrogen contain 2 atoms. So oxygen contain 1 atoms. So similarly, empirical formula of glucose. Empirical formula of glucose, that is CH2O. So, and glucose also indicate carbon 1 for hydrogen 2 and oxygen is 1. So note that the empirical formula only indicates the atomic ratio of the element present in the one molecule of the compound. Now let us look at the molecular formula. We take glucose for the molecular formula, that is C6H12NO6, which means C double bond O carbon H 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So Z bond OH, Z bond H, and C bond OH, and C bond OH, C bond OH, yeah, H. So this means one molecule of glucose has contained 6 carbon atom. 6 carbon atom and 12 hydrogen atom and 6 oxygen atom also. So molecular formula of glucose C6H12NO6 and empirical formula of glucose CH2O. So that molecular formula N multiply empirical formula, N is any integer, so N is equal to molecular mass divided by the empirical formula mass, sum of the atomic masses of the atomic present in the elements. Let us see, we have to make the compound in CH2. So empirical formula is equal to CH2, empirical formula of mass for the CH2 is equal to 12.0 plus 2 into 1.0, which means one carbon atom and one hydrogen atom. So the answer is 14.0 gram per mole. So the molar mass of CH2 that is 28 gram mole. So N is equal to molar molecular mass divided by empirical formula of mass is equal to 28 divided by 14. So when we multiply, when we divide, we get answer is 2. So molecular formula is equal to N into empirical formula, we get answer 2 into empirical formula is CH2, which means we get answer C2H4. This is the answer. So when to use this molar mass, composition, empirical formula and a molecular formula in chemistry, let us say we have to conclude the experiment and obtain the compound. So let me take the example of elements sodium, sulfur and oxygen. Percentage composition for sodium is 29.11 and the percentage of sulfur is 40.51 and for oxygen 30.38 and the molar mass is 158.1 gram. So here I'll ask one question. How can we determine the empirical formula and molecular formula of this compound, which means sodium, sulfur and oxygen? There are the four steps are there. First we have to convert the mass percent to grams. So since we are having the mass percent, it is convenient to use 100 gram of the compound as the starting material. So for sodium, percentage composition is 29.11, for sulfur 40.51 and for oxygen 30.38, and we know that the molar mass is 158.1 gram. So we should convert it the percentage into gram. So we get answer 29.11 gram and 40.51 gram and 30.38 gram. So second step is determine the number of moles in each element. That is our second one. So moles of an element, mass of the element in grams divided by atomic mass of the element. So we know that for sodium, percentage of composition is 29.11, 40.51, and 30.38 is for oxygen, and we know that the molar mass is 158.1 gram, and in gram we will change this, percentage composition is 29.11 and 40.51 gram, 30.38 gram. So this is only we have to get, which means relative atomic mass only we have to identify it. So moles of the sodium, that is 29.11, 23. So we will get answer when we divided this 1.266. So here we will write for sodium 1.266 and for sulfur 40.51 divided by 32. So we get answer 1.266. So for sulfur, relative atomic mass is 1.266. And for oxygen, 30.3816. We will get answer 1.897. So for relative atomic mass for oxygen is 1.897 answer. So we can get the number of moles in each element. That is, as we write the same things, 29.11 the same value for molar mass also. We will change it gram. Sorry, 1.266, here also 1.266, 1.897. So for number of moles in each element is 23, 32.1 and 16. For one change ma, it should be come here and it should be come here. And the third topic is calculate the simplest molar ratio. That is molar ratio, moles of the element divided by the smallest quotient. So the smallest quotient is 1.266. So the moles of sodium 1.266 and 1.266. So when we divided this, we will get answer 1. And here also for sulfur also 1.266. 1.266. So when we divide, we will get answer 1. But for the oxygen, we will get a different answer. That is 1.89 divided by 1.266. So we will get answer 1.5. So the moles of ratio is 1.5. So in the ratio is not a whole number, then the multiply number with the suitable integers to convert them into the whole number. So in this case, if we multiply all the value, this all the value by 2, we will get answer the ratio is 2:3. So we will get the ratio is for sodium 2, for sulfur also 2, and for mole oxygen also 3 only. So we get the simplest molar ratio is 1:2 = 2, 1 × 2 = 2, and 1.2 = 3. So the ratio is 2:2:3 only. So the fourth steps is write the empirical formula by mentioning the number of after writing the symbols of the respective elements. First write the elements of the symbol next to each other, that is sodium, sulfur and oxygen. The second step is then it said obtain the numerical value of simple whole number of mole ratio at the lower right hand corner of the each symbol, that is 2. The ratio is, simple ratio is 2:3. So this is the empirical formula. So now let us determine the empirical formula in mass. The empirical formula mass can be obtained by adding the atomic masses of all the atoms present in the empirical formula, which is 158.1 gram. So empirical formula mass 2:23.0 plus 2:32.1 plus 3:16.0 plus. So when we multiply these and add the answer, we get 46 plus 64.1 plus 48. So we get answer is 158.1 gram. So empirical formula mass is equal to 158.1 gram. Now divide the molar mass by the empirical formula for the identity the value of n. So n is equal to molar mass divided by empirical formula mass, that is molar mass is 158.1 only, and the empirical formula mass is same 158.1. so we get answer is 1. So n is equal to 1 only. Then the molecular formula of a compound can be determined by multiplying the empirical formula of the compound with n. So molecular formula n multiply empirical formula. So molecular formula of 1 into, so n we get answer is what, 1 only. So n multiply na 2 is 2O3. So in this case, molecular formula will be the same as the empirical molecular formula. So that the answer is na 2 is 2O3. So the molecular formula is na 2 is 2O3. So students, I hope you understand. Thank you so much.